you're watching this, make sure you follow my boy. Share all the stuff. Subscribe. Share it with your people, man. He's the voice of the streets, voice of the community, voice of business, voice of black culture, man. Make sure y'all listen to your boy.
All right. My roundabout is we done made it to Hattie B's over here on 8th Avenue. This is my first time ever coming to Hattie B's. You know what I mean? Like I said, I ate at Prince's Chickens plenty of time, but I never ate at Hattie B's. I done drove past this place numerous of times, plus the one downtown. It always got like a crazy line, but I actually came here to get some of their wings. It's similar to Prince's Chicken. They got hot wings. But what I'm doing for the vlog, which I never really do, is eat that hot stuff like that. So I'm gonna get the hottest. I'm just gonna get one though. So I'm gonna get one, just one, because I don't wanna get all that shit hot and then don't wanna eat it. But if you look at it, this they menu right there say the heat levels. They actually let you see the heat level first, which if you see right there, they got Southern, mild, medium, hot, damn hot, and then shut the cluck up. And that shut the cluck up is the one I actually just got one of. So like I say, he actually said that I just wanted to get like one wing, because I don't really do hot shit, because real hot food ain't really good for your stomach. But if you look at the rest of the menu, you know what I mean, they got bone served with two sides, so you get a small dark, small white. They got wings, which is three whole wings. You get a half a bird, which is $14, which that's pretty cool to get a half a bird, which, you know, if you get two of them, that's $28 for the whole chicken. That'd probably be a good meal. Then they got chicken sandwich, they got chindas, they got chicken and wings and waffles. He said they waffles probably about that size, so I probably say they're probably about the size of that lid right there. Yeah, but and then you look at their size, they got pimento cheese, see it right there. They got pimento cheese, fries, bacon grits, southern greens, baked beans, red skins, creamy coleslaw, baked eyed peas, and they say everything is a la carte. And then they got the dirty bird fries, which is fries with pimento cheese, some dark meat bites, and comeback sauce. They got fried pickles, and they got the little uns. They got banana pudding, peach cobbler. They got floats and ice cream. And then they actually got some chips right here. You know what I mean? They actually got some beers, things like that. Then they actually got some paraphernalia on the wall, cool hats. Got some shirts for sale, stuff like that. Pretty cool hats. You know what I mean? Look at the hat right there. You know what I mean? Pretty nice. I wish they had a shirt. I wish they had a shirt that said that. That's a pretty cool restaurant. Pretty nice sized restaurant. But I'm gonna go ahead and get my food, and I'm gonna catch y'all in a minute.
All right, my roundabout is okay. The food then came, so we got the three regular wings. I don't know why they put pickle on their stuff. They always do that. They're kind of crazy, but got regular chicken wing right here. You know what I mean? Look nice and crispy. You know what I mean? They got some grits. Actually got some grits right here. Definitely gonna check this out. Thanks. Some ice cream. I guess that chicken must be. Hell nah. I'm laughing. That chicken gotta be hot because she just brought me some ice cream. So that's crazy as hell. But yeah, man, I got some grits right here. Definitely smash on these grits. You know what I mean? Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Them grits is busting. Them grits busting, y'all. Like, no lie. I ain't just saying that to say it. Them grits get a 10. God damn, this doesn't even taste like grits. How do you get the grits to taste like that? No. I'm like, no bullshit. I don't know how they got that grits to taste like that. That don't taste like grits. That is bananas. And I got some baked beans right here. I mean, got some baked beans. Now, baked beans taste good as hell, too. God damn. Hattie B's, I know y'all had it cracking like this. I'm a big name ain't here. Like, chicken look fine. And then we got some waffles right here. You know what I mean? Definitely gonna smash on these waffles. And then that's that real hot piece of chicken, which they told me to eat last. So, and then she brought, see the ice cream got to, the chicken got to be hot. She brought me some ice cream, and I ain't order no ice cream, so they let you know how hot that chicken is. But anyway, you see, we got the chicken. So we got the chicken and the waffles, and we got food. So we about to go ahead and smash on this food. But them grits, God damn! If I would've known these grits were that good, I would've got some more of them grits. I mean, them goddamn grits are hot. I mean, no. I think I ate a pickle that got some of that sauce on there. My lip burning like a motherfucker already. But them beans fire too, damn. Beans fire. Beans fire. But y'all see food. Y'all already know. I'm about to smash on this food. I'm about to straight smash this food. Sweaty bean. Bean fire hell. I'm very satisfied with this food. Already. Like, no BS. And you got some whipped honey. Some whipped honey spread. Put it on my waffles. God damn. Them beans fire. I did not know they food was this good. I'm kind of mad at myself that I never came here to eat. And that's some good ass butter. Give me a minute, y'all. No. Hey, I ain't bullshit, y'all. Look. Hey, look. Look, I'm talking, I done killed it. I want some more. I don't even want no more of this food. I want some more grits. Shit. I ain't never taste grits that good. Ever in my life.
I ain't never taste grits that tastes good. It gotta be like.
Right. You hear me talking? It gotta be. It gotta be something in these grits, man. God damn.
What it do, man. I done made the Hattie B's. My first time ever eating at Hattie B's. So right now I got 3 chicken wings, which I just got mild.
Jesus Christ. I'm not BSing, man. Damn. Like, no. I'm getting some more before I go home. Them grits. God damn. We just come here and eat sides, B. God damn. Like, nah. Nah, man. I ain't that hungry. I ain't lying. This is amazing. All right. No book. No. Damn, this food is amazing. They fried the shit out that chicken. Good ass waffle. I gotta get some napkin. Hold on. line. It's some good ass food. Like, we ain't done about. Ten restaurants. Well, probably 10 or more restaurants. I'm not even lying. We've been some nice places. By far, this is one of the best restaurants I've been to. Like the texture of the waffle. Like the texture of this waffle is crazy. So, the last few days, I have not been feeling like myself. You know what I mean? I have been feeling like myself. I feel like, I know y'all been hearing me talk about this a lot. Probably if y'all just don't watch all my videos, but I'm trying to make that transition, man. I don't know what that transition is, you know, just trying to figure it out. You know, because I'm tired of just going with the flow. And I've been going with the flow of life my whole life. You know what I mean? So, waiting for some stuff to change. So, reading something, which I got 5 months of life. It say, right now you're being pushed to take life seriously and mature. If you're not being true to yourself or tend to compromise your needs, you'll feel the consequence during this cycle. You'll encounter limits and boundaries, heavy pressure. They say these 9 months are a reality check. This is an amazing window of opportunity to make some serious decisions about who you are and where you're headed. During this cycle, you're being asked to look thoughtfully and objectively at what it is that isn't working in your life. That's what I'm talking about. They say it's not a time for play or escapism. It's time to course correct if you're headed in the wrong direction. You'll know if you're off track during this time because you'll really feel it. You'll be met with noticeable limitations and boundaries, forcing you to rethink your commitments. And I mean, y'all been hearing me talk about money a lot. Like, money, money, money. Even though I'm doing this, man, I gotta eat. And I'm just doing this for content also, because I can eat regardless. But, you know, and I love doing this for the YouTube, but, and it's real. So, it actually says, if you're used to slacking, coasting, or avoiding practical reality, the pressure you're now facing will make it difficult to be complacent. You're being encouraged to work hard and take life seriously, to channel this energy toward being productive. You're being pushed to mature. If you struggle to embrace your authentic self and continually compromise your needs, you'll feel the cost that you'll feel that right now. Life may feel empty or depressing, like something's missing. Don't ignore these feelings. The heaviness is motivating you to make a change. It's a sober and serious time that can be overridden by trying to escape in ways that you normally make you feel good. It can feel like your dopamine and endorphin levels are diminished, like you're hitting a wall. Could I stop drinking? You feel me? You know, I used to drink beer, but I stopped that. So, you know, and I can just feel it too. You know, just trying to make these little small, minute changes. You know, just trying to figure it out. You know what I mean? So it's like, just slowly making those, you know, them transitions. You know, because life ain't easy. You know? Having know, having three kids to look after, make sure they good. You know what I mean? Running a business. Yeah, but it also say a sense of being physically drained to drag down and force you to face objective reality and the cold hard facts of your situation. But this is also an opportunity for you to align with this, what's possible. This cycle empowers you to figure out where you blocked and then successfully eliminates what's preventing you from moving forward. But adjustments are required and action is to be taken. Even if it's painful, don't be afraid to go. To let go of any person, career, behavior, or environment that isn't serving you, who you are. This way you can clear space for something new to emerge. The intention is to motivate you and adapt to grow. And then it says, it's time for endings and beginnings. If you feel your efforts aren't producing results, you are constantly meeting resistance, then assume things aren't intended to work out and move on. The danger during this time is to dismiss what you feel or try to override the limitations and power through instead of seeing what they are. The barriers you encounter are intent to teach you. Pay close attention. You'll be given clear and fair feedback during this cycle, even if it's not what you hope for. And that's all I've been hearing, so yeah, man, I gotta make some changes, man.
Like, I guess I can understand, like, the kind of thing, but that's it.
Yeah, gotta make some changes. But I'm working towards that too, though. So. So, I'm gonna take them other two wings home. I might try this hot ass chicken. Pray for me. I don't even want to do it. I swear I don't. I'm gonna eat a little piece of my other chicken first. And see this mouth, right? Like that chicken mouth. Like, this chicken is mild and it's hot to my mouth. Dude, I don't even wanna. Shit. I don't know what I got myself into, y'all. I think I'm about to back down because I'm fucking mouth hot now. Wow. Why my lips hot? My lips shouldn't be hot. That shit get on my lips. Yeah. Hell no. Nah. Hell no. Nah. Like no, nah, man. Hell no. Nah. Hell no. <nah. laughs> Ain't no way ain't no way that I just got that shit on my lips and my lips is hot. I mean, my lips is on fucking fire right now. God Damn. What the fuck? I'm gonna be able to do it, dude. In there, look. I just asked somebody in there, have they ever ate this hot? And as I'm asking him, he looked like he crying, whole face red, and lips look purple. Man, please. I don't think I'm gonna be able to make it, man. But we gonna attempt it. Definitely gonna attempt, man. I think this is suicide. I might go home and go to sleep after this, man. Hey. Jeez. And I'ma hold it with a napkin because I don't want this shit on my fingers, man. I'ma start off at the back end, man. I'ma start off with the smallest part. All right, man. Oh, man, I don't think I should eat this, man.
Yeah, good catch. Oh, okay.
I don't think I should eat this. Take it like a little small bite, like that shit look dangerous, man. Like, look at the sauce, look at it, man. That shit look dangerous. Look at it. That shit look dangerous. Dangerous, man. I don't know. Let me just sit here and think about it for a minute, man, cause. My lips was just hot as shit. And I just got some on my lips. I had just got some on my lips, man. We debate. It's gonna be tough.
Hey man, here's a free grits on the house for you.
I appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
You said you liked it, so we give you another one.
Alright, thanks. See? Free grits. Hey man. So there's three restaurants in a row where I got something free. And they're just talking to the people, man. Just telling me you like something, man. It's actually good though, I will admit. Like, I can't believe it's that good. Like, it's that good. But y'all heard it, free grits. We gonna take a bite of this goddamn chicken tender. Go ahead and take a bite. Man up, T.Y. Man up. Shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit.
The whole formula can?
Oh. Oh shit. Shit.
Oh. You're not hungry?
Oh.
Oh. You don't want to eat?
Oh.
Oh, you're done. Okay. Still
hungry?
Yeah.
Oh.
Hey. Yeah. She's lying.
Right. Like, I can feel like it's in my nose.
Oh. Like. No wonder she went like this. Oh,
I might eat this shit. Yeah. Nope. That's my reaction. I'm getting mad. Good on that. I'll never eat that again. Yeah, I never eat that again, y'all. It tastes good. I admit that. It's good going down. I mean, it's good in your mouth, but once it heat up, it's hot. Like, my lips are hot. Like, Jesus Christ. If I can sit my lips, like if I could literally like take my lips and just sit it in this water right now, I would. God damn. I don't even know why they make stuff that hot. That ain't even comfortable to eat, man. Yeah, I just stick with the math. Shit. And then a lady in there, she asked me, do I want the rest of her hot chicken? Hell no. I wouldn't even give that shit to a homeless man. That shit right there. Look. And I ain't even eat it all. Like, that shit gotta be for kicks. That shit gotta be for shit kicks and giggles. I tell you this much though, my sinuses feel like they clip. Shit, the restaurant closed. Alright, y'all. Alright. Jesus Christ. Jesus. The food, I ain't gonna lie, it definitely, everything get a chin. Like I said, that hot ass chicken is hot, it's good. It ain't even hot in my mouth, it's just my lips. I got these big ass lips. But yeah, man, some good food. I definitely come here again. I just come here just for some grits and some baked beans. I don't even care for the chicken. I mean, I just came here to, you know, just to vlog, but you know, like I said, another episode of Around Nashville at Hattie B's, man. Good food, good people. Dude gave me some free stuff, so that's cool. But I'm about to get ready to head home, finish editing. Like always, man. But like always, one love. Love thyself, man. Remember, you gotta love yourself before you love anybody else. I mean, you can love your cat, but the cat not a human. You know what I mean? Or you can love your dog. I just heard something about a lady just left a dog $2.3 million. Like, I don't get when people leave dogs money. Like, what the hell a dog gonna do with $2.3 million? Like, shit, I wish I knew that lady. I'd be a goddamn dog. But anyway, before I start running my mouth, man, like always, man, one love, love thyself. Can't love nobody before you love yourself. And on that note, like always, man, peace.
If you're watching this, make sure you follow my boy, share all the stuff, subscribe, share it with your people, man. He's the voice of the streets, voice of the community, voice of business, voice of black culture, man. Make sure y'all listen to your boy.